Special request by a fellow called Rafa Diaz on the Fractal Audio XFX 3 forum, who mentioned in one of my threads that he wouldn't mind hearing my take on the classic Dave Friedman amplifiers. So I have put together this suite of 8 different amps or variations on BE100s and small box and stuff with some suitable effects either side of the amp and the cab, and I give it to you for your rocking pleasure. This is a Charvel Dinky. It's got a lovely Seymour Duncan custom, I think, in the back, which is a nice kind of medium humbucker, and I've decided to calibrate it with it. Let's have a look at these scenes and a bit of an explanation of what is going on. So scene one, as you can see, is the Friedman BE, otherwise known as the old Marsha in brown eye mode. And rock it does. Now, cabinet-wise, you will normally find on most presets, including those from the Fractal Factory, hello Matt, the Legacy number 60 or even the 61, which is the Fractal Greenback with an M160. And it is fat as hell. But I have today, just because I like want to be different, teamed our amp up with a whole lot of Marshall Greenback cabs, two from Ohnhammer, and a couple of others on the end here. I can't remember where they're from, but they're all factory. And they've just got a little less mids and a little less punch. So you can decide between them and B channel or the C channel for the extra fat one yourself. They're all in there ready for your rocking pleasure. Scene number two, back to the amp block here, brings in the brown eye with the C45 switch, which is basically a bit of a mid scoop if I'm not mistaken. Now you can hear that I've got the delay block and the reverb block turned on there as well. There are two delays that I've put with this preset. That one, and if I press my foot switch here, the mono tape delay, which is more reminiscent of an Echoplex. In fact, I've stolen the settings from Guitar Nerd's Wheeze thread the other day. Thank you very much, whatever your real name is, whoever your real name is. So you can decide between A and B. Reverb block is the same. You've got two reverbs, a medium room. I'll just turn that delay off. And a big plate. While we're here, we should look at some of the other effects that are available on tap as well. Starters, we've got the chorus. Slightly modified digital stereo. Then we can have a look at the flange, excuse me, the flange effect. And the phaser. again, both lifted, borrowed, or however else you want to describe it, from the Guitar Nerds Wheeze, EVH Phaser Flange and Echo matched preset that he put up the other day. Thank you very much, sir. I appreciate it. The Friedman BV2 features in scene number 3, which is the Brown Eye 100 with the mids engaged, so a little more chocolatey. Particularly if I kick in the drive, which is an 808. Scene number 4, the Friedman HBE, which is the Marsha in honey brown eye mode. The difference between those two delays. Scene number 5, down to amp block number 2 here, is the Brown Eye 100 in HBE mode. They're all pretty similar, just subtle differences. Number 6 is the HBE with the C45 engaged. So if you like that sound, you might want some mids, you want to kick the drive in. Ferocious. Can imagine what that's going to sound like at full volume. Number 7 is the HBE with the mids, switch engage. Again, that's a good one, possibly for lead sounds. Could muse myself for hours. And scene number 8 features the small box. You can see that I haven't deviated much from the input drive control here, so it's at halfway. You can alter that. The gate is set up for this guitar to keep it quiet. If it's off, there's a difference. And wood expander, I like it. There's a wah as well, which can be, which actually is auto engaged. You want to check that. Disengage that auto foot control pedal number 1 if you don't want to use it. There's a rotary in there as well, which I haven't really calibrated, so we won't go there. And there it is. I'll upload it. Have fun. See you next time.